Alright, our next presentation on a very intriguing animal. In fact, I even had a talk with Mrs. Vanneke about this animal the other day because she was so intrigued by it. The brown-throated three-toed sloth. Let's welcome Mrs. Macy. Miss Macy Burton.
The classification, its kingdom is Animalia, which stands for animals. Phylum is Chordata, which is stands for chordates. Subphylum is Vertebrata, which stands for vertebrates. class is Animalia, which is mammals. Then Pelosa is their order, and that stands for sloths and anteaters. Their family is Bradyrhynchidae, and that stands for all three-toed sloths. And genus stands is Bradypus, which that also stands for three-toed sloths. And then their species is Bradypus berychates. They are closely related to the armadillo and the anteater. Their physical characteristics. They have a brownish blonde coat. It is very thick and woolly type, but they are also very, very dirty. They get algae in their hair, so which makes it have a greenish tint in their fur. There's a picture of green fur. They're different things. The male weighs about 4.45 kilograms, while the female weighs about 4.22 kilograms. And the male has two yellow stripes running down his back, while the female just has a plain brown back. Distribution. They live around South Central America and South America, so they're all the green is where they usually live. Their habitat, they live in tropical rainforests, semi-deciduous forests, subtropical forests, and subtropical lowlands and swamps. But they also seek trees with large crowns exposed to sunlight, and their elevations are at sea level to 2,400 meters high. Their conservation status, they are at least concerned, which is the top of the list, and their pop trend is unknown, and they are increasing. Okay, reproduction. The females are monogamous, which means that they only give birth to one child per year, and the female attracts the male when it's ready to mate with a loud shriek, and if that one baby per year, and it's prior to rainy season, and the females will usually mate with the first male they meet, and the males are mature around 4 years, but the females are mature around 3, and the females spend half a year in pregnancy. Parental care. They're with their mom for 5 years, and that includes gestation, and their father takes no help with the care. Longevity and mortality. They live up to 30 to 40 years in the wild, but in captivity, there is no difference. Seasonal patterns. They have no behavior changes. They do not hibernate, migrate. But they do undergo torpor. Excuse me. They, because in South America, it usually just stays warm the whole time. Their diet, they mainly eat leaves from the trees, but they also eat fruits, vegetables, and they get water from the ingested plant material. Predator relationships. It is a spectacled owl.
the variety of felid cougars. And they have, unfortunately, no human relationships unless they're in captivity, which is not very often. So they, this is felid harpy eagle, and this is a cougar. Fun facts. Sloth, this is from Mr. Myers. Sloths need sunlight to digest food because they will die if they have a full stomach. Sloths have excellent camouflage. One, for they move slowly, and they stay really high up in the trees, so it's kind of hard to see them behind the leaves. They have a shriek when they use their ready to mate, and their claws can make really deep cuts in our skin. Questions? Carl.
Is it three-toed?
Yes. Travis.
How did you do the top of the name?
It didn't say that. It just said they make big deep cuts, but maybe not as, probably not deeper than an inch. Caleb.
Has a sloth ever killed a human?
No.
Nice question.
I might have missed it, basically, when I was giving your water. What did you say about the human relationship?
They have no human relationships, unfortunately.
Like none?
No. Only if they're, like, in captivity. They like, just feed on them.
So, like, humans, like, don't eat them or anything like that?
No. They just sleep on them. So that's why their population is
stable. Okay. And then, so, explain the sunlight thing to us.
Oh, okay.
So they're not plants. So is this an evolutionary linkage?
No,
why do they
this
need
is
sunlight?
Not. They, where is it? Okay. So this is one of the facts that Mr. Van Keith really liked. They need sunlight to digest their food. I don't know why, but it's just a thing they need. Because if they have a full stomach, well, it takes a month or over a month to digest their food, a full meal, and the sunlight helps it. Kind of like photosynthesis. I don't know why, but it's just something they have.
They would not do too well in Washington, then, huh?
No.
All right, skip me.